This morning we started discussing about the importance of saying 100 blessings a day. I gave it very briefly, the importance. I went through the count, how we do that, which I'm going to now say it again because some people had some questions on it and I didn't take into consideration that I was counting according to how I pray, and according to the Rama, it's a little bit different. So very briefly, I'm just going to go what I said in the morning and other options, and then we'll go into the class. So according to the Rama, he counts it from Arvit. So there are four blessings in Kriyat Shema and Arvit. Then 18 blessings, which can be counted as 19 blessings in Shmona Esre, and then one is Hamapil. Then in the morning, you have one on Etilat Yadayim, one on Asher Yatzar, one in Elokai, and then 15 of Birkot HaShachar. But then again, there's going to be a little bit difference in Ramah, Shulchan Aruch, and Sidurim. I said in the morning 20 because I come from my Sidur. According to the Ramah, like I said, one Netilat Yadayim, one Asher Yatzar, one Elokai, and 15 Birkot HaShachar, which brings it to 18. Then the Ramah adds another two brachot, which I have counted that in Birkot HaShachar. The Ramah counts it separately and he calls it Birkot HaTorah, so that's another two. So either way you're looking at it, we still reach to that 20. Tzitzit one, Tfilin one, the Ramah says two. And of course women don't put tzitzit and tfilin. And then Baruch She'amar and Ishtabach, you have another two. Kriyat Shema of Shacharit three. Tfilat Shmona Esre, 19, Mincha 19, which brings us to, I calculated in the morning, 89 brachot. The Ramah says it's 91 brachot, and even 93, if you said the tefillin, and so forth. And that's not included, and the Ramah is not including here Birkat HaMazon. Excuse me. And then, of course, you have extra brachot. If you travel, you do Tfilat HaDerech. If you happen to be called up to the Torah on a Monday, on a Thursday, then you have the bracha before going to the Torah, after going to the Torah. There's always going to be addition brachot, and needless to say, the rest you can add later. Excuse me. And it's a little bit less relevant right now. If it's 89 brachot, 91 brachot, you have to reach to the 100. So if you started with 89, so do you have 11 to catch up? If you started with 91, then you have 9 to catch up and so forth. And besides that, the Shulchan Aruch says, lefachot mea brachot, at least 100 brachot. Today we're going to focus on the 100 brachot. I don't know if I'll be able to squeeze in one class everything that I wanted to say. Thank you so much. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Shehakol Nehiya Bidvaro. See, did you hear ching? You heard it? I guess you didn't hear the ching. So, first of all, there's a lot what to cover. There's a lot of sources, a lot of information about specifically this 100 brachot. We might have to do two classes. I will first quote the Talmud in Tractate Menachot, page 43b, Daf Mem Gimel Amud Bet. And it says there, Tanya, we have learned, Haya Rabbi Meir Omer, Rabbi Meir used to say, Chayav Adam Levarech Mea Brachot Bechol Yom. A person has to bless, say 100 blessings a day. Where is he bringing it from? Shene Emar, and he's quoting a verse from the Torah in the book of Devarim, chapter 10, verse 12, which is Parashat Ekev. And the verse says there, Ve'ata Israel, and now, O Israel, Ma Hashem Elokecha Shoel Mimcha, Kim Li'ira, and so forth. Go to the verse and you'll read the verse. And he's quoting, Rabbi Meir is quoting this verse. This is the source for the 100 brachot a day. Now, how did he get to Dafka from this verse? If you take this verse, go to Parashat Ekev. It's in the book of Dvarim, chapter 10, verse 12. It has 99 letters in the verse. Now, what's the focus on this verse? That it says, Ve'ata Israel, and now, O Israel, what? So he's focusing on the word ma, and he says, don't read it ma, read it me'a. Now, when you add the aleph to ma, that makes it 100 letters in the verse. That's the drasha of Rabbi Meir, and that's how he gets to 100. Comes on that a little bit of I don't know if to say a twist. We call it a chidush or something to enlighten.
Innovation.
That I liked. Now, so Rabbi Meir says, don't read it ma, rather read it mea. Mea means 100. You add the aleph to the ma, you get 100. We talked about it the other day, about a certain way of learning things by switching the order of the letters. This is called chilufei otiyot. The most common one is called atbash. Atbash means that the letter aleph is switched with the letter taf, because aleph is the first, taf is the last. The letter bet is going to be switched with the letter shin, because second in line. If you take the word ma and you switch it to atbash, you will get two letters, tzadik and yud. Tzadik is numerical value of 9, yud is the numerical value of 10, 90, sorry, thank you. Tzadik is the numerical value of 90, yud is the numerical value of 10. There you have, again, the 100. If I'm going too fast, let me know. I just want to try to pack into the little time that we have as much as information as possible. So we already have one beautiful source from the Talmud. Now, another interesting chidush is that in the time when they built the tabernacle, there was many different pieces. One of the most important pieces were the sockets. This is called adanim. And why is it most important? Because it's holding the entire foundation. And if you would miss one of the sockets, then there's a foundation will not stand. And I mean, the right word, of course, Lashon Kodesh is adanim. Now, if you go to the text, you will find something very interesting, that there were 165 sockets. And I'm going to stop saying sockets, I'm going to say adanim. There were 165 adanim. 65 of them were made of copper, and 100 of them were made of silver. And these were the foundation of the entire Mishkan, the entire tabernacle. Therefore, we learn from that the 100 blessings a day is the foundation of my Mishkan, my tabernacle, as the Kadosh Baruch Hu instructed us, v'asitim li mikdash, v'shachanti betocham. Build for me a tabernacle, a sanctuary, and I will dwell in you. So I am Hashem's tabernacle if my behavior is appropriate. So the 100 sockets, adanim, correspond to the 100 brachot that I have to say every day. And there we have another way how we approach the idea of the 100 brachot a day. Next, it says that when a person says 100 brachot a day, it removes from him any type of prosecution, any kitrug, and not only that, it's strengthening the physical power of his body. I'm just quoting very quickly many different sources. Now, another interesting information, where did we get to the 100 brachot? So, if you look in the Talmud and the Zohar, it says that when Adam HaRishon, Adam, was created, he was so tall that his feet were on the ground, v'rosho magia shamayma, and his head was in the heavens, better to say in the firmament. He was so huge. Then when he, and why is that? Because Adam HaRishon was created to connect the physicality and the spiritual world. So most of his body was in the physical world, his head, which is called the mochin, the intellect, was in the world above, connecting the spiritual and the physical. But after he sinned, the Zohar says, Nafal mi madregato, he fell down from his level, his spiritual level, but the Talmud says that Hashem shrunk him, and Hashem squeezed him from the head down to the height of 100 amot. Now, amma is not really a foot. Amma is about 50 centimeters, which is a little bit more than a foot, but the Talmud says that he squeezed Adam HaRishon to the height of 100 amot. Just imagine, if it's 50 centimeters, you're talking about 50 meters. That's how huge Adam HaRishon was, and this is according to the Talmud, of course. And from that, again, we derive that a big tikkun, a rectification for the sin of Adam HaRishon, is by praising the Kadosh Baruch Hu, blessing him 100 times a day. And of course, there's much more to it. The Zohar says, I wanted to give a class about the Zohar. This, I think, we might have to do in a different class. because there's six different places in the Zohar that is talking about the 100 brachot. In general, what the Zohar is saying, that when I say a blessing, the term that it's using is either sewing or knitting. Because the Zohar says, kosher ktarim. So, likshor is really to tie. But really, what it means is that I sew a crown. So the Zohar says that when a person says 100 blessings a day, kosher me'aktarim laKadosh Baruch Hu. It's like I'm crowning the Kadosh Baruch Hu. I'm the one who's creating the crown to the Master of the Universe, 100 of them a day. That's what the Zohar says. And then the Zohar goes into extreme long length. I'm just going to quote a few interesting things. And Bezrat Hashem Lineder, maybe we'll do some classes from the Zohar, but if you already want to look at it yourself, the Zohar is talking about that in Parashat Korach, which can be found in page 179, Kuf Ayin Tet, also in Parashat Truma, page 127, Kuf Kaf Zayin, in Parashat Lech Lecha, page Ayin Zayin, 77, in Parashat Lech Chayei Sara, Kuf Kaf Tet, 129, in Zohar Chadash, page Kuf Lamed Aleph, 131, just that you see how many places the Zohar is talking about this 100 blessings a day. So, I would like to focus on one thing that the Zohar says, that this is already explained by the Gaon from Vilna. The Gaon from Vilna was known to be one of the most in-depth interpretations and commentary on the Zohar. And he explains it as follows. We know that Samech Mem, the Satan, the devil, the Yetzer Hara, he has a lot of power against us. And his name is Samech Mem Aleph Lamed. We don't pronounce the name. Now, interestingly, this is as a side note I'm saying, the Samech Mem has control over us from all directions. What is the hint that the Samech Mem has control over us like that? This is what the Zohar says, like he has his hands wrapped around us. See the hand movement? You see? The Samech Mem has his hands wrapped around us. What's the hint for that? That we're now sitting in the land of Israel and we are surrounded by enemies. And the enemies that are surrounding us have the exact same letters of Samech Mem Aleph Lamed. Samech is Syria, Surya. Excuse me. Mem is Mitzrayim, Egypt. Aleph is Iran, and Lamed is Lebanon. So we are surrounded with countries that are our enemies and wishing to destroy us, that they spell out the name Samech Mem Aleph Lamed, the name of the Samech Mem himself, and the Zohar says he has his hands wrapped around us like that, that you can't move. And that's the case with most of us, that he has us in his hand. What does the Zohar says? The name Samech Mem Aleph Lamed, you have to cut it in half. The end half, Aleph Lamed, that's a holy name, by the way. So that's the Nitzotz Kedusha, that's the holy spark that enlivens him. But since it's the next part of the name, so it's weakened. But has to have some type of a godly spark, even in the Samech Mem. So the Aleph Lamed is a holy name, and that's the good part, the Nitzotz Kedusha in him. But the Samech and the Mem, Samech is numerical value of 60. Mem is numerical value of 40. You get 100. And when we say 100 blessings a day, but not this is not a bracha, by the way. This is not a blessing. Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech Ha'olam. Pronouncing the words. You don't have to make a show. Some people make a show. This show you can keep for Hollywood. I'm not going to, don't want to insult anybody, but some people, oh, they go, come on, just say it like how it's supposed to say. We don't need the show. And you know what's usually the ones who are making a show? At home, they don't do that. They're doing it next to people to appear to be very pious or holy. But if you say the bracha the right way, and you have some type of intention, and you don't butcher the words, and you're focusing on it, then when you say 100 blessings a day, you have the power to release the achizah, the grab of the Samech Mem from you. Just see how powerful is something so small, but yet so huge, And again, the brachot have to be pronounced the right way. You can't butcher the words. You can't swallow the words. You have to have separation between the words. You can't say it fast so that it will sound like one bracha, one sentence. And we went through that many times. It has to be done the right way. So how do you sweeten the judgments, the attack from the Samech Mem? How do you get the achiza? Achiza means a grab off, a grip. Then you say 100 brachot a day with all your might, with all your intentions. So this is again one powerful source in the Zohar that I feel that it's very important for us to follow and to take. Like I said, maybe we will do a class just on focusing on the Zohar. It has a very interesting insights to give specifically on that. Now, there's a big halacha argument if the 100 brachot is deoraita or rabbanan. We're not going to get to the halacha argument because a lot of people will not appreciate the depth behind it. I can tell you that many claim, many, when I'm saying many, I'm talking about Ramban, many Gdolim, that some of them claim that it's deoraita. The Rambam, for example, he says it's the Rabbanan. Rabbanan means that it was incorporated by their rabbis. But to many sources, this is deoraita. The Gaon Chida actually says that it's not David HaMelech who decided to do the 100 brachot, rather Moshe Rabbeinu, that this is Kabbalah LeMoshe MiSinai, that Moshe received that in Sinai while he was on the mountain. And later on, we do know that at the time of David HaMelech, there was a plague, and 100 men were dying every day from the plague. What did David HaMelech do? He decided to make a campaign. Instead of calling the campaign 40 days, like how we named the campaign, he made a campaign. Everybody has to say 100 blessings a day. And David HaMelech did what's called a takana. Takana is an addition to the halakha, or to the law, or to the mitzvah. It's above it. And we see many times the word takana. It says David HaMelech tiken mea brachot beyom. He added it. Now, how did he get to 100? Besides that 100 men were dying every day, he said, okay, there are 98 curses in the Torah, and on top of that, there's another two curses that it says, choli umachala. And when do you say that? Kol achol yasher samti alecha b'mitzrayim lo asim alecha. All the disease that I have put on you in Mitzrayim, I will not put on you. If you read the whole verse, it's saying when a person follows the Torah and follows what the Torah tells us to do, then Hashem says, I will protect you and I'm not going to put any disease and affliction on you. David HaMelech took the 98 curses and the times that it says in the Torah, choli and machala, which is a disease and a sickness, or maybe you can translate it a little bit different. And for there he got to 100. And the 100 brachot, they fight the 98 curses in the Torah, and the twice that the Torah says that chas v'shalom, a person can become sick, and therefore the plague stopped. Now, the Gaon Chida, he says, it wasn't David HaMelech that did it. Rather, I mean, he did the takana, but it's not that he invented it. Rather, Moshe Rabbeinu brought it down, Kabbalah MiSinai, he received it from Hashem directly in Sinai, and since at the time of David HaMelech it was stopped, then it brought a plague. So David HaMelech just renewed it. He just says, listen, you are not following what Moshe Rabbeinu told us, therefore we're getting the plague. And what's the hint? Is the 100 people a day die. I think even when Corona started, there were a few rabbis who were trying to push towards a 100 brachot a day campaign, comparing it to the time of the plague with David HaMelech, that will stop the plague. But of course, the source is exactly what I'm explaining to you now, that the whole thing happened at the time of the plague, during the time of David HaMelech. Now, we don't have much more time. I'm just going to say one more thing. And Bemet Bli Neder, maybe we'll do another class quoting more the Zohar and other sources. But I think we have enough juice for today to ignite us to understand the importance of saying 100 brachot a day and focus on the brachot. And make sure that you're saying at least 100. Doesn't mean that you get to 100 and that's it. You don't have to say brachot. At least 100. And needless to say, you want to say as much as possible, because some of them maybe you didn't say with the right kavanah, so it's not going to hold strong. But this is enough to put the awareness and the desire on each and every one of us to focus on the brachot that I say. Don't say it so fast. Now, another thing that I want to add is that it says on the nation of Israel, Ve'amech kulam tzadikim, your nation are all righteous people. And it says a person has to be a tzadik bechol yom. You have to reach to a level that you are righteous every day. Why is it for specifically the word tzaddik every day? And how do I reach to a level of tzaddik? So, of course, you have to behave appropriately. You can't sin all day long and then do what I'm about to tell you now and you're good to go. This is where people distort the Torah. And you know, it says in the Talmud that if you say three times a day, Ashrei Yoshvei Vetecha, you are guaranteed to go to be in the world to come. So some people say, oh, great. I'm going to sin all day long, and I'm just going to say three times a day, Ashrei Yoshvei Vetecha, and there I have my ticket. So that doesn't work like that. If you have to do, you have to live your life as an observant individual, do tshuva for your sins, and as an addition, if you say Ashrei Yoshvei Vetecha three times a day, Muftach lo makom ba'olam haba, you're guaranteed in the world to come. And that's why a lot of people distort many things. You have to, you know, not too long ago somebody told me that there's a quote from the holy Rabbi Nachman from Breslev who says, if you will come to my tziyun, to my grave, and you will drink the tikkun haklali and put some coins to tzedakah, I will pull you out of Gehenom. So that's what people do. They go once a year and they dance in Uman and do the tikkun haklali and put some there, and they think that the rest of the 364 days of the year, they can do whatever you want. That's not what Rabbi Nachman said. He says, if you live your life as a God-fearing Jew, and you try your best, and then you add on that, I will fight for you to pull you out of Gehenom. But it doesn't mean that you party for 364 days of the year. So here we have a quote that it says, Adam chayav liot tzadik bechol yom. You have to try to reach to a level of a tzadik every day. And there's a beautiful explanation. What do I need to focus on every day to elevate myself? And this is something that we're trying to do in the last 40 days. I mean, last 10 days for another 30 days. And by the way, this morning I said that maybe we should do it 120 days. I said maybe we should do 40, 40, and 40, like Moshe Rabbeinu. So we got a few hundred comments on the internet that people said, yes, let's do 120 days. So we might do an extension. But just to focus on this so we can conclude the class, there are a few things that one should do every day that will help you to ascend to a higher place, to strive to be a tzaddik. Now, tzaddik is a righteous individual. Tzaddik, you write tzaddik, daled, yud, kuf. Now let's start dissecting it. Tzaddik is the numerical value of 90, and we do know that we have to say at least 90 amens every day. I don't know, we didn't even touch that yet, but besides that, you have to say 100 times brachot a day, you have to say 90 times a day amen. And you have to say it amen the right way. So when there's a shacharit and micha, there's the repetition, you can't look at your phone or read or whatever, you have to listen to the bracha and answer amen. That's why our sages say that amen is more important than blessing. So you have to say 90 times a day amen. So this is the first task. Find 90 times somebody saying amen. And it's easy if you're praying just with mincha and shachrit mincha and arvit, you're already squeezing in there already 60, 70 amens. All you need to do is a few other amens and you're good to go. And the amen has to be with all your heart. Amen, the acronym of amen is El Melech Ne'eman, a trustworthy king. That's saying, in other words, and I say something and you say, I affirm. Amen is basically saying, I agree with you. And if I don't answer amen, you don't agree with what I just said? So amen is agreeing with me and affirming that what I said is valid in your eyes too. So 90 times amen a day. Dalet of the word tzaddik, dalet numerical value is 4. You have to say 4 times a day kedusha. When do we say 4 times a day kedusha? One of them is in the paragraph of Yotzer. If you remember, we say kadosh, kadosh, kadosh. This is kedusha. Then we say another one in Shacharit, in the repetition, Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh. Then Uva Letzion, that's after Shacharit, we say Uva Letzion Goel, there's again Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh. And in Mincha, in the repetition of Mincha, again Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh. 4 Kedushot a day, therefore you cannot miss Minyanim. You miss Minyanim, you didn't say Kedushot. So the Dalet, the numerical value of 4, you have to do 4 Kedushot per day. Then you have to say 10 Kaddishim a day. The Yud of Tzadik, Tzadik Dalet Yud, so the Yud, numerical value of 10, we have to say 10 times a day Kaddish. You don't have to say it, but you have to be present when Kaddish is said. How did we get to 10 times Kaddish? In Shacharit we say 4 times Kaddish, in Arvit we say 4 times Kaddish, and in Micha we say twice Kaddish. And if Chas v'Shalom, lo aleinu, there's an orphan or a mourner in the Minyan, then he will say more Kaddishim, and therefore we're just adding more Kedusha. And to many, they have the custom that after a Shiur Torah, they will say Rabbi Hananiah ben Akasha Omer, and then we say another Kaddish. Of course, we want to add as many Kaddishim per day, because Kaddish, we're going to make a whole course about Kaddish, by the way. We're going to make a whole course about Kaddish. It's going to be a course because there's so much more to teach about it. But really, Kaddish is when you're looking at the words, the first two words, they reveal everything. Itgadal veitkadash. The name of Hashem should be great and exalted and be holy. Right? So the Kaddish is something very powerful to focus on. So we have to say 10 Kaddishim a day, at least 10 Kaddishim. 4 in Shacharit, 4 in Arvit, 2 in Mincha, and that's how you reach to 10 Kaddishim, which comes to teach you that when Kaddish is said, you don't talk, you don't eat, you don't chat, you don't read, you stop where you are, because you have to hear the Kaddish. A lot of people, they run with their prayer, or they talk, or they think Kaddish is a break. Kaddish is not a break. Kaddish is for you to listen. And if you are lagging behind the Minyan, then catch up. And if you are not running with the Minyan exactly, then stop yourself where you know Kaddish is about to come. It's as powerful as Kedusha. You know, if you're not running with the Minyan, and you're going to miss Kedusha, stop in a place where you have a gap to wait to hear Kedusha. Don't miss these things. That's why it's very important that you pray with the Minyan. Some people, the Minyan is slow, so they run fast. Sometimes the Minyan is fast, they run slow. You have to be with the Minyan. Why? So you don't miss the Kaddishim. You don't miss the Kedushot. All these things, for us, we take it like, okay, what's the big deal? Saying Amen, Amen. No. These are the keys to the vaults in the world above to be elevated every day more and more and more. So again, the word tzaddik, tzaddik, dalet, yud, kuf, tzaddik, numerical value of 90. This is 90 amens you have to say a day. 4, dalet, the numerical value of dalet is 4. 4 kedushot. Yud of tzaddik is numerical value of 10. 10 kaddishim. And now we're left with the letter kuf. Kuf is the numerical value of 100. And from that we take that we have to say 100 brachot a day. And if I do all 4 that I just told you, you will not be a tzaddik. But if you conduct your day in the appropriate manner, you will be bechezka. You will be like a tzaddik. You will be elevated to a higher altitude that you have much less of a yetzer hara, much less of an evil inclination that drives you crazy, much less of desires and lusts and weird thoughts and all these things. I'm repeating myself. You will not become a tzaddik from doing these things. But you have to pretend at least. You have to mimic a tzaddik. You have to strive to be in a very high level. And needless to say, that will be an elevator to a much higher spiritual level that will be able to assist you to go to these levels. So just to conclude, how important is the 100 brachot a day? And now we added on that the Kaddishim, the Kedushot, and the Amenim. But what I want you to take from that is the importance and the value and how much you need to focus on 100 brachot a day, which means that it's very important that we're meeting Minyanim. Don't discount the power of a Minyan. More than that, it's important that the bracha that you said you're focused on, don't say it fast. Focus on the words. You don't know the words? Sit with somebody to teach you the words. If you don't understand, you don't know it off by heart, don't say the blessing off by heart. It's not good to say the blessings off by heart. Read it from a prayer book. And if you don't want to carry with you around a prayer book, then I told you already, all the Judaica stores, they have these little laminated cards that has all the brachot on it. Keep it in your wallet. Or keep it in your pocket that you can come and look at it and read it the right way, that you pronounce the word the right way. I hear people how they say brachot, half of it is that they don't pronounce their words right. And of course, when you're saying an oath by heart, then you get confused like that. All it takes is somebody to tell you something and you lost your focus. Now what's going to happen? You say a blessing in vain. This is another thing we're going to discuss, the severity of saying a blessing in vain. So you want to bubble yourself and isolate yourself for 3 seconds when you're saying a bracha, that you're focused on the bracha, look at the object. I don't know if I should say an object, but look at the object you're about to eat before you say the bracha. You're about to put tefillin? Take 3 seconds to meditate. Wait a minute, I'm going to put tefillin on right now. What is the bracha? Asher kitchanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu laniach tefillin. So not long ago, I said laniach tefillin. Somebody told me, no, it's not on hanachat tefillin. He says, what? He's like, I've been for 4 years saying hanachat tefillin. I said, why don't you look at the siddur? But that's how I was taught. So 4 years, you're putting tefillin, and you're not saying the right bracha. So focus on the bracha. You're about to eat something, look at what you're about to eat. You're about to put your talit on, you're about to go up to the Torah. Sometimes people come up to the Torah, they're so excited. Relax. Take a deep breath. The minyan will wait another 3 seconds. Meditate. What an auspicious moment. I'm next to the Torah. Show me the bracha. Don't say it from your heart if you don't know. So we have to take not only the importance of saying the brachot, how I say the brachot, the kavanah behind it. And I just gave you now a very quick overview of what we achieve from that, what we can reach from the brachot. Don't disregard it. Don't minimize it. I guarantee to you, you put a lot of weight and emphasis on the brachot you say every day. I guarantee to you, you'll be in a totally different spiritual altitude that will assist you to go closer and closer and closer to the Kadosh Baruch Hu. And really, that is our aim. To be as close as I can to the Kadosh Baruch Hu. Because when I do the opposite of Hashem's will, then I go away from the Kadosh Baruch Hu. And these are little things that will get guaranteed to get me close to the Kadosh Baruch Hu. Needless to say, the Kiddush Hashem, the sanctifying the name of Hashem, when I crown the Kadosh Baruch Hu 100 times with crowns, that I publicly state to the world that the Kadosh Baruch Hu is the master of the universe. Don't be embarrassed when you say brachot. Sometimes people sitting in a crowd. Now you don't need to now make a joke out of yourself and make a whole announcement, but say the bracha out loud. First of all, you want somebody else to say amen. And you don't, but you wanna, you feel embarrassed to say a bracha next to people? Say it out loud. Some people say, sorry to tell you, that's not a bracha. Now you don't have to scream it. Some people, I told you, some people make a show. Don't make a show because you're making a fool out of yourself. Say it normally with all the intention and know that you're sanctifying the name of Hashem when you're saying that. And needless to say, especially when we're focusing now on 40 days to beautify the Kadosh Baruch Hu, sanctify His name. This we have here an unbelievable key, an unbelievable jumping board to jump to the next level, and needless to say, to cause unbelievable nachat, joy, happiness to the Kadosh Baruch Hu. Yesterday, I don't know if you noticed, I was saying Lichet L'Shem Yichud Kudsha before Arvit, and then I said out loud, did you hear what I said? Lasot nachat ruach leyotzrenu. To make, how would you say nachat ruach? Nachat ruach is to cause unbelievable peace and pleasure to the Kadosh Baruch Hu, ve'lasot retzon borenu, and to do the will of my master. So I screamed it out loud, only Yaakov heard. Maybe other heard, but nobody said, yes, I heard you. But I said it especially out loud, when you finish the L'Shem Yichud Kudsha, is these 2 words, lasot nachat ruach leyotzrenu, to cause joy, happiness, and nachat to my creator, and to do the will of the Kadosh Baruch Hu. So let's do a lot of nachat to the Kadosh Baruch Hu, and by how? By fulfilling the will of Hashem. Tov. Lech tagid la banot.